A funny thing happened to some astronomers who were using the Hubble Space Telescope to study stars in a nearby cluster. They found something hiding behind the cluster, a distant, undiscovered galaxy millions of light years away. Welcome back to Launchpad. I'm Christian Reddy, your friendly neighborhood astronomer. A team of astronomers using the Hubble Space Telescope were investigating a nearby globular star cluster called NGC 6752. Globular clusters are populations of older stars that are arranged in a spherical or globular shape, hence the term globular cluster. These clusters orbit our galaxy in a halo surrounding the Milky Way. Each cluster contains upwards of tens of thousands all the way up to a million stars each. The stars in these clusters are pretty old. They're at least the second generation of stars born in the universe, and there may even be some first generation stars still hiding in there. Most of the stars in these clusters have long since died out, leaving behind their now exposed cores called white dwarfs. A team of astronomers led by Dr. Luigi Bedin were using the Hubble Space Telescope to understand how the white dwarfs in NGC 6752 cool down over time. Globular clusters are rich hunting grounds for white dwarfs, which by their very nature are very faint stars. As the team were inspecting their Hubble images, however, they discovered a population of stars that were even fainter than the faintest white dwarf in the cluster. The team immediately suspected that this was in fact a distant galaxy, specifically a spheroidal dwarf galaxy. Dwarf spheroids, like the Fornax dwarf shown here, are typically found as satellites to much larger galaxies. In fact, dwarf spheroids often crash together in the early universe, building up, over time, the large galaxies that we see today. So whenever these galaxies are found in isolation or surrounding a larger galaxy, they're pretty much undisturbed fossil records of what the early universe was like. Dwarf spheroids resemble globular clusters. After all, they're both, well, spheroidal in shape. But globular clusters are much smaller and much more densely compact than dwarf spheroid galaxies. But in order to confirm this new object was in fact a galaxy, the team needed to figure out just how far away from Earth it really is. To do that, they examined each and every star in the background galaxy and compared each star's color to its apparent brightness. This results in a diagram like we see here called a color magnitude diagram. The cooler the star is, the redder it appears. And the brightest and reddest stars are red giant stars. These are stars that were once much like our sun, but have since expanded several hundred times their previous radius. Oh, and by the way, we're going to be talking about the sun's fate in an upcoming video, so stay tuned. Anyway, the red giant stars were of particular interest to the research team because they have a fairly well-known luminosity. That is, we know how bright these stars really are. So by comparing their known luminosity to their apparent brightness, the team are able to work out just how far away these red giants are, and therefore how far away the galaxy is. Turns out it's about 28 million light years away. Sure enough, the team did in fact find a brand new galaxy, designated Bedin I. Now we're going to find out more about this galaxy in just a moment, but first I want to thank my Patreon supporters for their generous support. Patty Broussard, Neil from Crypto Cruising, Eric from Modern Day Tech, John Cannon, Aaron Wilson, and Garoth Balion. And I want to welcome my newest Patreon supporter, Jennifer Brozak. Thank you so much for your support, it really helps a lot. Bedin I is about 4 degrees in the sky away from NGC 6744, a huge grand design spiral galaxy in the constellation Pavo. That puts Bedin I about 2.1 million light years away from NGC 6744. So it could mean that Bedin I is a distant satellite to the larger galaxy, or more than likely it's a standalone dwarf. The team didn't just work out this new galaxy's distance, but they also measured the galaxy's overall metallicity. In astronomy, we define anything that's heavier than helium as a metal. So yes, oxygen is a metal. You're breathing metal. Anyway, Bedin I's low metallicity means that this galaxy and its stars are very old, at least 10 billion, but possibly as old as 13 billion years. That puts Bedin I at about the very age of the universe itself. Now, a dwarf spheroid galaxy like Bedin I may not be resplendent with gorgeous spiral arms or bursts of star formation or wonderful, neat structures, but they are fundamental building blocks of our universe. By making a complete census of each and every galaxy, no matter how small, we can build up a much better understanding of the current present-day structure of the universe. But by comparing our local universe with the most distant clusters of galaxies, we can compare the modern-day universe to the universe as it appeared billions of years ago. That means that we can better understand not just how the universe is put together today, but how it evolved over time. Now that is really exciting stuff. So far, it looks like Bedin I is the most distant standalone dwarf galaxy yet discovered. But that galaxy is a population of stars, many of which were once just like our sun, but have since expanded into red giants. Now, if you'd like to learn more about how our sun will one day become a red giant and meet its fate, well, make sure that you subscribe and ring that notification bell so that you don't miss out on any new videos. And speaking of subscribing, I can't believe I'm thanking 5,000 of you who have subscribed and joined me on this journey through this amazing universe of ours. Wow, what a thrill. I can't believe it. I'm so thankful to have every one of you. And if you would like to help support this channel so I can keep making more videos like this, please do feel free to hit me up on Patreon, or if you prefer, get yourself a nice t-shirt. We'll probably put some other swag up there pretty soon. So check out my Teespring store, and thank you all so much for your wonderful and generous support. Until next time, stay curious, my friends.